As opposition leader Martin Fayulu was driving through the streets of Kinshasa, the police stopped his car and dispersed protesters with tear gas. Officers were filmed striking supporters. Opponents believe Mr. Fayulu is the true winner of last year's election and that the country's current president is working for his predecessor, Joseph Kabila.
Today, we are being attacked by police officers sent by Kabila and Tshisekedi. How can we understand what is going on here? All the cars had their tires punctured. The police are taking money and phones from peaceful citizens. Journalists are being attacked. Cameras are taken from them. But what have we come to?
In an interview with France 24 earlier this week, the Congolese president denied allegations that he was a puppet. And he also said that Saturday's demonstration, which was banned by the city's governor, would be prevented but not repressed.
The rights and the freedom of citizens are guaranteed, but we are under the impression that some confuse democracy and anarchy. We cannot, when an authorization is given to march, accept that people attack peaceful citizens or degrade public infrastructures. The security forces are trained to uphold peace. There will be no repression.
In Kinshasa, most people complied with the government ban. Only several hundred people came out in support of the opposition. In the eastern city of Goma, the police used live rounds to disperse the crowd.